नमस्कार, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. दिस इज प्रोफेसर रिपुर रंजन सिन्हा, प्रमोटर ग्लोबल इनोवेशन, पीस एंड सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट इन लाइन विद यूनाइटेड नेशन सस्टेनेबल एजेंडा 2030, अफ्रीका डेवलपमेंट एजेंडा 2063, युगांडा डेवलपमेंट एजेंडा 2040, and India Growth Index, Development Growth Index, India 75. Professor Information and Communication Technology, associated with one of the prestigious institutions at the Pink City, Jaipur, Rajasthan. As a Professor Information and Communication Technology, and citizen, Indian citizen, today, I came and discussing the part 3 of the Atmanirbhar package by the Government of India. In my previous video, I already shared part A and part B, part 1 and part 2 related to poor and MSME. Today, we are discussing about the Atmanirbhar package part 3, especially based on the agriculture. What are the benefits of the agriculture and agriculture list given by the Government of India? So let us start. Prime Minister Narendra Modi Sahab started on the 15th May 2020, announced related to the farmer 30,000 crore additional emergency working capital for farmers of the NABARD. NABARD will extend an additional refinance support up to 30,000 crores over the above 19,000 already being provided by NABARD for medium crop loan requirement of the rural cooperative banks and RRBs. Will benefit 3 crore farmers, mostly small and marginals. 2 lakhs crore credit booster to 2.5 crore farmer under Kisan Credit Card Scheme. A special drive to provide a concessional credit to PM Kisan beneficiary through Kisan Credit Card. Fisherman, animal husbandry farmer will also included in this drive. Will inject additional liquidity 2 lakh crore to 2.4 crore farmers. Agriculture, additional step during the COVID, a number of measures supporting farmers' expense. Additional measure taken 2 months out of the low. During lockdown period, minimum support prices, purchase of amount more than 74,300 crores, PM Kisan Fund transfer 18,700 crores, PM Fasal Bima Yojana claim payment 6,400 crores rupees. Animal husbandry, additional step during the COVID, during lockdown, demand by milk reduced by 20 to 35%, 560 lakhs liter per day procured by the cooperative against daily sale of 360 LLPD. Total 111 crore liter extra procured, ensuring payment of 4,100 crores. A new scheme to provide interest subventions at the rate of 2% per annum to dairy cooperative for 2021. Additional 2% per annum interest subventions and promote payment interest servicing. This scheme will unlock 5,000 crore additional liquidity, benefiting 2 crore farmers. Fishery, additional step during the COVID. All 4 COVID-related announcements for the fishery implemented. Validity of sanitary import permitted for the import and setup board was extended by 3 months. Condiment delay up to 1-2 months in arrival of the board stock consignment. Allow revoking of the quarantine cubicle for the cancelled consignment with no additional charges. Verification of document and grant of NOC for the quarantine relax after 7 days to 3 days. Registration of 242 registered shrimp hectares and Nepali reacting hectare expiring 20 extended for the 3 months. Operation of marine capture fisheries, aquatic culture relaxed to cover inland fisheries, especially in the agriculture. Government has given lots of support, boost up support to do activity, but information need to be recalculated. So measure to extend infrastructure, logistics, and capacity is taken by the government of India. It's a very, very remarkable step. So in this case, 1 lakh crore agri infrastructure fund for the farm gate infrastructure for the farmer. Lack of adequate cold chain, post-harvest management infrastructure in the vicinity of farm gate causing gap in value chain. Focus has been on short-term crop loan, while investment in long-term agriculture infrastructure has often not been enough. Financing facility for 1,000 crore will be provided for the funding agriculture infrastructure project in farm gate and aggregation point, primary agriculture cooperative society, farmer producer organization, agriculture entrepreneur, startup. Importance for the developing of farm gate, aggregation point, affordable and financial viable post harvest management infrastructure fund will create immediately. 10,000 crore scheme for the formalization of micro food enterprises. A scheme promoted vision, Honorable Prime Minister, especially vocal for local for the global outreach. Unorganized MEF need technical upgradation to attend FSSAI food standard, build brand and marketing. A scheme will launch for the help 2 lakhs MFE attend our goals. Existing micro food enterprises, farmer producer, organizations, self-help groups and cooperated to be supported. Cluster-based approach, Magno in a UP, Kesar in Jammu Kashmir, Bamboo Shoot in the Northeast, Chili in Andhra Pradesh, Topicoa in the Tamil Nadu, expected outcome to improve health and safety standard, integration with retail market, improve income, will also help in the reaching untapped export market in view of the improved health consequences. So 20,000 crore for the fishermen through the Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana. Critical gap in the fishery value chain. Government will launch the PMSSY for the integrated, sustainable, inclusive development of the marine and inland fishery. 11,000 crore for the activity in marine, inland fishery and aquaculture. 9,000 crore for the infrastructure, fishery harbor, cold chain, markets, case culture, living farming, ornamental fishery, as well as new fishing vessels, traceability, laboratory network will be activities. Provision of ban period, support to the fishermen during the period fishing and not forfeited, personal boat insurance, will lead to additional fees for production of 70 lakhs ton over 5 years, employment to over 55 lakhs person, double export one crore. Focus on inland Himalayan states, northeast state and Asparagus district. National Animal Disease Control Program. National Animal Disease Control Program for foot and mouth disease and varicosis launched with the total outlay of 13,343 crores. It is your 100 vaccination of cattle, buffalo, sheep, goat and pig population. Total 53 crore animal at India. 53 crores animal for the foot and mouth disease and for the varicosis. Till date, 1.5 crore cow and buffalo tagged and vaccinated. Animal husbandry. Infrastructure development fund around 15,000 crores. May any area in country with a high milk production having great potential for private investment in the dairy. Aim to support private investment in dairy processing, value addition and cattle feed for infrastructure. And animal husbandry infrastructure development fund around 15,000 crores will be set. Incentive to be given for established plant for the export for the niche products. Promotion of the herbal cultivation. Around 4,000 crore. National Medicinal Plant Board has supported 2.25 lakhs hectare area under the cultivation of medicinal plant. Okay, 10,000 hectare will be covered under the herbal cultivations in next 2 years with the outlay of 4,000 crore will lead to 5,000 crore income generation for the farmer. Network of regional handis for medicinal plant. National Medicinal Plant Board, NMPB 400. NMPB will bring 800 acre area by developing a corridor of medical plant among the bank of the Ganga. Beekeeping initiated 500 crore beekeeping in a lively support activity for the rural area, increase yield and quality of crop through the pollinations, provide honey and other beehive product like wax. Government will implement a scheme for infrastructure development related to integrated beekeeping development center, collection, marketing and storage center, post-harvest and value addition facility. Implementation of a standard and developing traceability system, capacity building with a trust on the women. Development of a quality nuclear stocks, bee breeder. This will lead to increased income of 2 lakhs taxpayers and quality honey to the consumers. So in this case, from top to total, 500 crore supply chain have been disrupted and farmers are not being able to sell their product in the market. Distressed sales and reduction of price of the perishable fruit and vegetable at the farm labor need to be prevented. Operation Green will be extended from the tomato, onion and potato, TOP, to all fruits and vegetables, TOP, tomato, onion and potato. Scheme phase will be follows 50% subsidy on the transportation from the surface to decent market, 50% subsidy on the storage, including cold storage. Pilot for the 6 months will be expanded and extended. Expected outcome, better price realization to farmer, reduced wastage, affordability of product for the consumers. So government and administrative reform is also taken by the government of India. Especially amendment to Essential Commodity Act to the enable better price realization to the farmer. EC Act 1955, Essential Commodity Act, EC Act 1955 was enacted in day of success. Need to enable better price realization for the farmer by attracting investment and making agriculture sector competitive. Agriculture food step including krill, edible oils, oil seed, pulses, onions, and potato to be deregulated. Stock limit to be imposed under very exceptional circumstances like national calamity, famine with a surge in the prices. No such stock limit shall apply to process or value chain provider subject to their installed capacity or any export subject to export demand. Government will amend it Essential Commodity Act shortly, that is 1955. Agriculture market reform to provide market choice to the farmer. Farmer want to sell agriculture product only to license to APMCs. Such restriction of sale is not there for any industrial produce. Result in the hindrance in the free flow of the agriculture produce and fragmentation of market and supply chain. Less prices realization for the farmer. A central law will be, is going to formulate it to provide adequate choice to the farmer to sell product produce at an attractive price. Barrier-free interstate trade. Framework for e-trading of agricultural products, agriculture produce, price and quality assurance. Farmer lack on the enforcement standard mechanism for the predictable price of the crops at the time of sowing. Private sector investment in the provision of input and know-how in the agriculture sector hindered. Facilitated legal framework will be created to enable farmer for engaging with the processor, aggregators, large retailer, unexpected, in fair and transparent manner, risk mitigation for the farmer, assured returns, and quality standardization shall form integral part of the framework. So, next, thank you. We will meet again on the part 4 of the Atmanirbhar Bharat shortly. Thank you. Till date, thank you. Till date, thank you for the till date. Bye bye. Thank you for the same. Thank you. Thank you very much.